Next Wednesday is going to be the most important evening in the Jewish calendar. We call it Seder night, and we normally associate Seder night with family, with friends, good times, laughter, fun. There's always that moment when you stuff yourself with the matzah and you watch as your friends have their little matzah bits coming out of their nostrils and you try and keep a straight face. You then gorge on this incredibly good food. You laugh with your friends. You're having such a great time. It climaxes with the Chag Gadya, where everyone gets a chance to be able to imitate their favorite animal and become like a spare part of the Madagascar movie. It's incredible. Everyone loves a Seder night. Seder night is all about friends. It's all about family. But what happens if you're going to have a Seder alone? What happens if there's a pandemic and we're forced to be alone and we do not have family and we do not have friends? Then what? I guess it's not really a Seder. It's kind of like a loser's Seder, right? Wrong. Completely and totally wrong. My dear friends, we need to recalculate and realize what we have next week is an opportunity of a lifetime. And allow me to explain. There's basically two types of Seders. There's the classic family Seder, but there's another type of Seder, which I call a hero's Seder. A hero's Seder is part of the Jewish legacy. Let me share with you a story about my teacher, Rav Shlomo Volba, of blessed memory. It wasn't really a Seder story, but after the Holocaust was over, he found himself in a country called Sweden, where he was building a orphanage for 200 kids that had just gone through the ravages of the Holocaust. He described to us what it was like to be the only rabbi, the only male in this institution, the first Rosh Hashanah after it was built. He had to go through the Rosh Hashanah prayers completely and totally on his own. He managed to get hold of a shofar. He blew it on his own. He was not a man of nostalgia, but he told us that that Rosh Hashanah was the Rosh Hashanah of his life, something he will never forget. He reached a level of devotion, of meaning in his prayers, that he never in his glorious life of teaching was able to replicate. Now, let's go back to a hero's Seder. You think about Seders of heroes of the past, the ones that made a Seder alone during the Holocaust, or maybe in the Russian Gulag, crazy stories like that. Well, you don't have to go to that extreme. You could have a hero's Seder in good old-fashioned New Jersey, or good old-fashioned St. Louis. All you have to do is say, here is my opportunity to savor something in a way that a communal Seder can never ever achieve. You say to yourself, I'm not gonna run away from this opportunity. I'm gonna embrace it. I'm gonna meet the challenge. I'm gonna step up to the plate. So let's begin with four rules. Number one, the very first thing is prepare for the evening. Prepare as if you would prepare for a marathon, for some athletic event. Learn up the rules, read it up, get yourself familiar. See what you can get and what you cannot get. Go in there prepared. Don't prepare absolutely every commentary. Leave something that fascinates you for you to actually read that evening, or maybe a story, or maybe some kind of an idea that's going to inspire you there on the spot. Rule number two, don't be harsh on yourself. It's okay to learn two words, good enough. Everything has to be good enough. It does not have to be perfect. Try your best. The third thing is don't rush it. Look at the words that you're saying and try and savor them. Try and think about what do they mean to you. Let your thoughts just go with the flow wherever it takes you. And just enjoy yourself. Step number four. Don't be afraid to sing if you know some of the songs and sing them on your own. Because I want to tell you a very, very important secret. That night, you're not really going to be on your own. That night, Hashem is going to be with you. God is going to be closer than ever. And Eliyahu HaNavi, Elijah the prophet, he's going to be knocking on your door. Don't be afraid to sing because you're going to experience a form of holiness that nothing else will ever compete with. Let's go back to my teacher, Rav Volba. Rav Volba used to say that once upon a time, heroes were these great rabbis and these great holy women that used to change the world. He said, today the heroes, the Jewish heroes, are Jewish teens, like Encius Wires. They're the real heroes of today. They're the ones who are not afraid. When everything's going downstream, they go upstream. They're not afraid to go and take a challenge like making their own Seder night. So I want to tell you a secret, that this year, we're hoping that the holy Melech HaMashiach, the Jewish Messiah, will come finally. And if God willing, he comes. So he's going to be looking for those heroes to say thank you. Don't be surprised if he comes and says, where are you? Because you're the one that brought me. You're the one that I want to thank. This year, my dear friends, this year, make this Seder the best one ever. Make it into a hero's Seder. Good luck.